In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, good morning. As we are again to celebrate around this table from wherever you are, to celebrate the love and sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Good Shepherd, let us call to our mind our sins and ask Him to forgive and to fill us with His love and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, perfect light of the blessed, by whose gift we celebrate the Paschal mysteries on earth, bring us, we pray, to rejoice in the full measure of your grace for ages unending. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The apostles and the brothers who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles too had accepted the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcised believers confronted him, saying, "You entered the house of uncircumcised people and ate with them." Peter began and explained to them step by step, saying, "I was a prior in the city of Joppa, when in a trance I had a vision, something resembling a large sheet coming down, lowered from the sky by its four corners, and it came to me. Looking intently into it, I observed and saw the four-legged animals of the earth, the wild beasts, the reptiles, and the birds of the sky. I also heard a voice say to me, 'Get up, Peter, slaughter and eat.' But I said, 'Certainly not, sir, because nothing profane or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But a second time a voice from heaven answered, 'What God has made clean, you are not called profane.' And this happened three times. And then everything was drawn up again into the sky. Just then three men appeared at the house where we were, who had been sent to me from Caesarea. The Spirit told me to accompany them without discriminating. And these six brothers also went with me, and we entered the man's house. He related to us how he had seen the angel standing in his house, saying, "Send someone to Joppa and summon Simon, who is called Peter, who will speak words to you, by which you and all your household will be saved." As I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them as it had upon us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said, "John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." If then God gave them the same gift he gave to us when we came to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I to be able to hinder God? When they heard this, they stopped objecting and glorified God, saying, "God has then granted life-giving repentance to the Gentiles too." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to the Lord. The responsorial psalm, your response shall be, "Athirst is my soul for the living God. Athirst is my soul for the living God." As the hind longs for the running waters, so my soul longs for you, O God. Athirst is my soul for God, the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Athirst is my soul for the living God. Send forth your light and your fidelity. They shall lead me on and bring me to your holy mountain, to your dwelling place. Athirst is my soul for the living God. Then will I go into the altar of God, the God of my gladness and joy. Then will I give you thanks upon the harp, O God, my God. Athirst is my soul for the living God. Alleluia, alleluia. I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice. And there will be one flock and one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In today's Gospel reading, Jesus assures us his followers two things while presenting himself as the Good Shepherd. He lays down his life for his flock, and he is faithful to his flock, even unto death. And we know that Jesus revealed God's faithfulness to us, and he loved us even when we put him to death. And he remains faithful to us even when we are less than faithful to him. And in today's Gospel reading, Jesus also declares that he wants his relationship with us, his followers, to be as close as his relationship with God, his Father. That is why he says, "I know mine, and mine know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know him." My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we know that Jesus has a unique relationship with God the Father, and that relationship is characterized by a profound, loving intimacy. And Jesus declares that in today's Gospel reading, he wishes his relationship with us, his followers, to have that same intimate nature. Jesus wants to be close to us as he is close to his Father in heaven. And he has done and he is doing all he can to make possible this intimate relationship between him and ourselves. It is up to us to respond to all he has done and all he is doing. If that intimate relationship is to become a reality, to respond, it is our responsibility to respond all he has done and he is all he is doing to make this intimate relationship with him a reality. And today's Gospel reading suggests that we respond by listening to his voice and allowing his word to make its home in our hearts. When that happens, we begin to remain in his love as he remains in his Father's love. Amen. Let us offer our prayers and petitions to God our Father, to Jesus Christ, our Good Shepherd. May those who do not believe come to understand who Jesus is, so that he may lead them into the community of the church. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. May we rejoice in the universal nature of the Church and welcome and accept every member with no hint of discrimination. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. May the Diocese of St. Augustine and the religious orders who serve here be blessed with vocations to the priesthood and religious life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. May we place ourselves under the divine protection of Jesus, the Good Shepherd. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. May the Good Shepherd hold tenderly in his arms all who suffer from the coronavirus. and lead those who have died to where they may enter through him the gate to a place that is safe. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And let us offer our own personal prayers and petitions to our loving God. If you wish, you can post your prayers on the comment section. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty, ever-living God, eternal health of believers, hear our prayers for your servants who are sick with the coronavirus. Grant them, we implore you, your merciful help, so that with their health restored, they may give you thanks in the midst of your church. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Blessed Mary, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, we come to share the divinity of Jesus Christ, humbled himself to share our humanity. Blessed Mary, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by the Lord and sacrifice this day, pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, my iniquities and cleanse me my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your heart. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, an integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with the Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Felipe Esteves our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased to you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. May this mingling of the body and blood of Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. And receiving the body of Jesus Christ, not bring me to judgment and damnation, but through your loving mercy, be for me protection in mind and body, and healing in life. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that under my roof, but only serve the word, my soul shall be healed. In the body and blood of Jesus Christ, keep me safe for eternal life. The act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Look with the kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying God by your lives. Thanks be to God. Have a blessed day.